Hey guys, Photoshop Pro Help here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create this sticker style text effect. So as we can see, this is the effect that we're going to end up with, and I'll also be showing you how to get this peel away effect, which is in the corner, which is fairly easy to do, and I'll explain a bit more about that later on. Now, first things first is we need a blank new document. Now to do that, we go to File and New, and you can have any size document that you want, so I'll leave that up to you guys. And then from here, we're going to go and colour our document. Now, I've coloured mine black. It's just so we can actually see what we're working with and we can see the text. So you can go for any colour that you wish. And then from here, all we're going to do is go over to our text tool on the left-hand side. Go up to the top. We're going to go and select the font as going to be Arial. So go and find that. We're going to put it to bold. And you can go for any size text that you want. And we're going to have the anti-aliasing set to smooth. Now what that does is it neatens all the edges out and it really smooths it all out, and we don't have any pixelated edges. So we're just going to go and set that to smooth. We can go and click on our document and we can go and start typing. So you can type in any word that you want. I've gone for this one right here, sticker, again. So once you have typed it all out, we can go and double click that layer to bring up the layer styles. So I already have all of my settings put in for me, as you can see. Now what this does is you can pause the video at any time if you get stuck, and you can see the settings for yourself. So I'm going to go down to drop shadow. You can pause the video from now just to check, but I will be going through them with you. So for the first lot of settings is going to be drop shadows, and the blend mode is going to be set to multiply. Color is going to be set to black. Opacity 45%. Angle 120 with use global light clicked on, distance 15 pixels, spread 13%, size 18 pixels, and we can leave the quality alone because we don't need to play around with that. So the next thing we're going to go and play around with is gradient overlay. Again, pause the video if you get stuck. Now the blend mode is going to be set to normal, differ is going to be unchecked, opacity is going to be 100%, reverse unchecked, align with layers checked on, layer style, which is going to be linear, and the angle is going to be 90 and the scale 100%. From here we can go and click gradient. Now you can go for any colors that you want, but I'll explain a bit about them first. So for the first color, which is going to be on the left hand side, click that. We have the color picker come up. Now we want to go for a dark color, so no matter what color that you're going to go for, pinks, reds, purples or greens or whatever, then you want a fairly dark color of it. So I've gone for a dark orange. You can follow me if you want, so the code will be FF7D00. Now you can pause the video and check out the code. Click OK. Now we're going to go over to the right hand corner, which is this color right here. And we're going to go for a light colour of the one we just picked. So if you've gone for a dark blue or a dark green, then you want to go for a lighter colour than what we just picked. So I went for a dark orange, so I am going for a very light orange for this. So the code for this one, if you do want to follow me, again, pause the video if you need to, FFA03C. Click OK once you've done that. And we're going to go and click once in the middle, and that adds another color. Now I've got two colors here, and I'll explain a bit about them both. So we're going to go and click once, and that brings up another color, and we want the same color code as the dark color for this. So we chose a dark orange, and I'm going to go for that same dark orange. So the code for this one is going to be FF7C00. Pause the video again, click OK, and we're just going to go to the right hand side of that, but still in the middle, click once again, and we add another color. Now the color code for this one is going to be exactly the same code as the light color that we just picked. So I'm going to go for that same light orange. So the code for this is going to be FFA73D. Click OK. And we have the light orange, and that's going to be a location of 51%. And the dark orange, we're going to have that as 51% as well. So put that as 51%. And we have them both in the same location. Then we're going to go and click OK. And we're going to go up to inner shadow now. pause the video again if you get stuck, blend mode, multiply, color black, opacity 14%, angle 120 with used global light clicked on, distance 5 pixels, choke 0%, size 5 pixels, and we can leave the quality alone again. Go up to stroke, and from here we're going to go to size, and we're going to put that to 24 pixels. Now it really depends on the actual size of your text, so you really have to play around with this. So the position is going to be set to outside, blend mode normal, opacity 100%, and for the fill type it's going to be set to color, and the color is actually going to be white. Now you can go for any color that you want, and we're going to go and click OK for this, and then we have something like that. Now if you do want to get the pullover effect, which adds to the sticker effect, then what we're going to do is we're going to go right click our layer, go up to rasterize layer style. From here we go over to the pen tool on the left hand side. Now we're going to go and take a corner off, so I'm going to go and select the top left hand corner of our S like this. Got to right click, going to go to make selection. We want a feather radius of 0 pixels, anti-analyze clicked on, click OK. We're going to go up to our quick selection tool on the top left hand side, right click where we just made the selection, go down to layer via cut, and we've just cut it onto a new layer. From here we're going to go and press Ctrl and T, or Command and T if you have a Mac, to free transform. Right click, press rotate 180, and then we can go and zoom in, and we can just go and position this to wherever we want it, to wherever it looks good, so around about there. Don't forget to use your arrow keys on your keyboard to position it a little bit better, so around about there for me. Click the tick icon at the top. From here we're going to go and double click that layer to bring up the layer styles, so I already have mine already set again. So we're going to go down to color overlay again, pause the video, blend mode normal, color is going to be set to white, opacity 100%. We're going to go up to satin, and again pause the video if need be, blend mode multiply, color is going to be set to black, opacity 31%, angle 126, distance 13 pixels, size 58 pixels, and we want anti-analyzed unchecked and invert checked, and for the contour is going to be set to Gaussian, which should be the 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 along, so that's the Gaussian one. Click OK, and we're going to go and add a few shadows into this. So we're going to go and make a new blank layer, so click the new blank layer in the bottom right hand corner. We're going to go and rename this to Shadow 1, like that, just so we know where we are. And from here, all we're going to do is go to a paintbrush tool on the left hand side, and we want a soft brush for this, and we want to put the opacity to around about 54%, color is going to be set to black, and all we're going to do is very lightly, is we're just going to go and paint in just along the edge, just along here, and as you can see it's added to the shadows. Obviously you're going to have a lot more time to make it neater, and we're going to go back down to the bottom layer now, and we want to go and press Control on our keyboard or Command and hold that down, and we're just going to go and select that, and we have everything selected. And we're going to go and make a new blank layer now, so bottom right hand side, click the new blank layer icon. And we're going to go and rename this to Shadow 2, just so we know where we are. And from here, using the same brush and the same opacity, we're going to zoom in. And all we're going to do is we're just going to go and paint in just softly, just so we can see a bit of shadow just coming over, so it looks like it's overlapping, and then Control and D, or Command D if you have a Mac, to deselect. And there we have it. That's your sticker effect done, and it was really easy and simple. Now from here you can go and add a lot more effects onto this, but I'll leave that up to you guys. Now I hope you liked the tutorial. Please comment, rate and subscribe guys. Go check out Facebook and Google Plus and my website. And if you want to support me, go check out the new t-shirt designs after this video. The link will be after. So go check that out. And I'll see you next time guys. Bye for now.